Hello, this is Greg Berg with Central Trust Company. Welcome to the Central View, our quarterly market update. As we kick off the second quarter of 2019, we'd like to talk about three things. First, we'll recap market activity from the first quarter. Then we'll look at the global investment environment. And then finally, our diversified approach to investing. So let's get started. In the first quarter, global markets posted broad-based gains across all major asset classes, which was the mirror image of the weak fourth quarter of 2018. The U.S. bull market hit its 10-year anniversary. The S&P 500 had its best start to the year since 1998, posting double-digit gains. What a difference a quarter can make. The market rebound can be attributed to the Federal Reserve's dovish pivot early in the year. The Fed appears to be on pause and may not raise interest rates at all in 2019. This has allowed interest rates to moderate. News that the U.S.-China trade talks were moving closer to a deal have also contributed to the market snapback. Now let's turn to the global investment environment, which has experienced slowing and less synchronized global growth in the second half of 2018. Recently, both the Eurozone and China have implemented new expansionary policies to stimulate growth. That, in combination with the likely prospects of a trade deal between the U.S. and China, are leading to the potential for global growth to stabilize and potentially uptick in the second half of this year. Here in the U.S., the economic environment continues to be favorable with low inflation and low interest rates, a strong consumer being aided by a robust labor market, and corporate profits that are slowing but still expected to grow 4-5% this year. Overall, the U.S. economy is in late cycle as the current expansion is 10 years old. If the current expansion continues until July, it will officially rank as the longest in U.S. history. Key factors that led to the market downturn in late 2018 have begun to fade, which allows global growth to improve. Those include the Fed pausing its rate increases, U.S.-China trade talks moving closer to a deal, China stepping up stimulus significantly to improve its growth, and the Eurozone economic data beginning to bottom. This combination of factors reduces the risk of recession over the next 6 to 12 months. So what does that mean for investors? The combination of slower global growth and an aging expansion leads us to favor more carefully balancing risk and return in portfolios. Looking forward, we believe the global economic and investment backdrop dictates a diversified approach to asset allocation and long-term investing. With an expansion that's 10 years old, we have reduced our overweight to stocks to neutral and are underweight to bonds as we have moved to a more balanced position. In a late cycle environment, we continue to carefully monitor economic and financial market data and stand ready to proactively adjust asset allocation and positioning. As always, if you have questions about your investments, we encourage you to reach out to your Central Trust Company portfolio manager. And for more information on the markets and our views, be sure to visit centraltrust.net.